Hi, I'm Angie, and you're watching Dante's 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 Vaccinating.
Dante's Boxing Nation, what's going on, guys? Before we start this video, let's go ahead and get into these plugs. Now check this out. If any of you guys want to learn how to speak and read the original biblical Hebrew words, I want you to go over to zionlawschool.org. You will receive an overview of Phoenician Hebrew, grammar, parts of speech, nouns, verbs, prepositions, etc. This brother that founded this website, he's a doctor, and he's a neighbor of mine, at least in a neighboring country. Because you know I live in Thailand and he lives in Vietnam. Now he's also selling 3 books, and each book that you buy comes with free online live courses. He has Phoenician Hebrew 101, I Can Read, and 911 Ibar Yath Rescue. So go ahead and start that free course by picking up one of his books on Amazon.com. I'll put the link in the description box. All right, let's get into it. So finally, with all these videos being made, all these reports from World Star Hip Hop to new media, finally, the Nevada State Athletic Commission, they respond to the many reports and allegations of Tyson Fury cheating with his left glove. As we all know, it's fact. This is not speculation when we say this. It's been proven beyond reasonable doubt that Tyson Fury's fist is at the bottom of his glove. You can clearly see that in all of the images. It's a fact that Tyson Fury, he has blood or some dark stain on his left hand wrap knuckle area towards the outer left corner. And it's also a fact that in the last 2 fights with Deontay Wilder, Tyson Fury was constantly illegally punching with his glove open. And the gloves were flapping back and forth as if his hand or his fist wasn't even in the glove. So with all that evidence being presented to Nsac, they responded, but they didn't respond publicly. They responded to the many fans that were once again sending them messages demanding some type of action, demanding an investigation. And this was Nsac's response. I'm going to go ahead and read exactly what they said. Remember, keep in mind, this is an email response to one of the many fans that was demanding an investigation. So this is what Nsac said. Thank you for your recent inquiry to the Nevada State Athletic Commission regarding the Wilder versus Fury 2 event on February 22nd. As a regulatory body, the commission administers the state laws and regulations governing unarmed combat for the protection of the public and to ensure the health and the safety of the contestants. In the performance of those duties, no irregularities or deviations of the statutes of regulations governing unarmed combat pre-event, during event, or post-event of February 22nd have been found. Now guys, listen to what they just said. They just said their job is to look after the health and the safety of the contestants. And they said they see no irregularities. So in other words, they're saying that it's regular to hit someone with your knuckles or with your fist being at the bottom of the glove. Now let's take a look at the rules of boxing. I have it on the screen right now. The highlighted area reads, you cannot hit with an open glove, the inside of the glove, the wrist, the backhand, or the side of the hand. Now understand something, guys. It would be different if somebody threw a couple punches with an open glove. But Tyson Fury, he did this 2 fights straight with Deontay Wilder. And when you put together the fact that he was punching with his glove open, and now we see pictures of his knuckle being towards the bottom of the glove, that alone is supposed to warrant an investigation based on the rules of boxing, based on Nsac saying their job is to monitor the safety and the health of the contestants. So after all of these images, either Nsac is telling us they make an exception with fighters on a coincidental list and they don't care about their health, or they're just telling us they're extremely incompetent. Or it could be because they're willing to protect Tyson Fury at all costs because Tyson has that wonderful hope insurance that clearly covers everything. Any type of incident, it covers. With that being said, I gotta show some more love to my sponsors by shouting one of them out. And then I'm gonna finish my response. Now, before I get started, I wanna tell you guys about this great book named Growing Pains by author Audrey P.A. The story is about a woman that goes through some extreme trials and tribulations at the hands of many male counterparts and how she became stronger and determined to change her life for the better. So go ahead and support this up and coming author Audrey P.A. by going over to Amazon.com and picking up yourself a copy of Growing Pains. I'll put the link in the description box. So back to Nsac. You know, I don't think the Nevada State Athletic Commission realizes that email they just sent to that fan could easily turn into a class action lawsuit where they could lose tons of money just because they admitted what their job is and then they're electing not to actually do what they say their job is. I mean, it's like a patient going to the hospital telling them something is wrong with him and they say, no, we don't believe you. You don't look sick enough for us to take this seriously. So you just go ahead and go home because I don't see any irregularities. I mean, this is pretty much what Nsac just said in that email. See, the fact of the matter is, Nsac, they don't want to investigate this at all because they know once they start an investigation, then the boxing world will be aware of it. And then it becomes public news that Tyson Fury has been investigated by Nsac over his controversial gloves. And they don't want Tyson Fury to get that type of negative attention because they believe, regardless of what they say or how the investigation turns out, it'll still put a dark cloud over Tyson Fury's win. But guess what, Nsac? There's already a dark cloud over Tyson Fury's name. Guess what, mainstream media? There's already a dark cloud over his name, regardless of you guys report it. In fact, this is making the story bigger that mainstream media is ignoring it. And some would even say covering it up. I mean, once again, when you look at how far people are willing to go to protect Tyson Fury, it makes you wonder, are there other things that's going on behind closed doors that's being covered up we don't even know about? I mean, guys, you have to realize how big this win is to a lot of non-black fans, particularly white fans. I mean, for them to find out that Tyson Fury cheated in a fight like this that means so much to them as a boxing fan, do you know how much that would break their heart? I mean, some of those type of fans will probably never even recover from it if that happened. Imagine the whole fight being overturned or something like that. Yeah, some fans wouldn't even be able to recover from it. So once again, at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter if Nsac does an investigation or not. Like I said, you know, the fact that they're trying to cover it up and they're trying their best to protect Tyson Fury by all means necessary, that's just making the story even bigger. Now, they probably would have been successful at burying something like this maybe about 30 to 40 years ago. But with the emergence of social media, it's impossible. It is completely impossible. So I'm gonna get ready to wrap this video up so I can start working on my next Tyson Fury video. Before I do, let me go ahead once again, shout out some of the sponsors that show that love to me. I'm showing the love back. Now I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this video up by shouting out two brand new YouTube channels. First up is my man King Sensei. He has a new YouTube channel. He covers hip hop, he covers UFC, boxing, and all the other sports. He's also giving away $100 to the 1,000th subscriber. Then we have my man Nate Drink One. He's a 10-year Marine Corps vet. He also has a new YouTube channel. And since I've been promoting him for what, the last couple of days, his YouTube channel has already went from 60 subs to almost 400 subs. This is, matter of fact, that's an old image you guys were just looking at with the 287. Yeah, but he covers boxing, he covers hip hop battles, he covers all the sports, and he also has a good podcast. It's kind of an ESPN style podcast show called A Drink of Wisdom. So I want you guys to go ahead and show that support and subscribe to King Sensei and subscribe to Nate Drink One. Let's help these brothers get to 1,000 subs. You know, it don't take nothing but a minute to hit that subscribe button. I'll put their links in the description box. Not only are you supporting their channel, but this is a great way for you guys to support what I do over here at Dante's Boxing Nation. That's all I got for now, guys. I'm on to the next one.